voor Mailchimp.
The Indiana high school football season starts on Friday, featuring several key games, including Northrop hosting Homestead. The Bruins finished last year at 3-7, and the Spartans went 7-4. Both teams are eager for the 2019 season.
We're really excited. I mean, having the scrimmage last Friday, it's a big build-up to the next Friday after that. And we're getting prepared at practice, and we're being led by a great coach, and we're just really excited to go out there and show everybody in the SAC what kind of team we are this year.
This is something we've been waiting on for a long time. We've been working hard since last year. They left a sour taste in our mouth, and we're just looking to bounce back.
Both teams have several playmakers, including at running back. Northrop has two solid backs in their backfield, those being Jeremiah Green and Demarius Cowan.
Once me and him get to a momentum of going, there's no stopping us. He got speed, and he also a power back, and I'm the vision, and I got speed.
Homestead returns Braden Hardwick. Hardwick is a junior and a second-year starter. He rushed for over 800 yards last year.
Last year I had a decent season, I feel like, and this year I've built more confidence with myself, and so hopefully I can do better than I did last year because I'm a lot more confident myself.
At quarterback, the Spartans plan to start Luke Goody, who split snaps with Jake Archbold last year. He completed over 58% of his passes and threw 11 touchdown passes.
His development in the offseason has been tremendous. You know, athletically, physically, he's done a lot of work in the weight room, which you can tell, and mentally, he's even sharper this year, as you would expect, coming from a sophomore year to a junior year. And he's advanced exactly the way we expected him to, so he should have a really good season.
Meanwhile, for the Bruins, Dylan Hoot and Issa Tachari are battling for the starting job. As far as who will start Friday night, the Bruins plan to evaluate that during the course of the week.
We have a pretty good idea of what we want to do on offense. There's a chance we might play both of them. There's a chance that one of them wins the job, but we're kind of still, it's kind of wait and see here.
The quarterbacks will also have some quality weapons to throw to. Northrop has quality receivers like Adrian Scott and Adrian Sewell, as well as 6'3" Quaylen Pettis, who's good at winning one-on-one matchups.
We've got quite a few weapons, so we feel like defenses can't really key on any one guy, which is to our advantage.
For Homestead, leading receiver Griffin Little returns after recording over 900 receiving yards last year. Though he is coming off an off-season injury, he is expected to play on Friday night.
I think he's done about as well as anybody we've ever seen come off an injury. I mean, he works his tail off, and he works on the mental part of it. He works on the physical part of it. So he's as ready as anybody could expect him to be at this point.
With all those playmakers on offense, that could pose a challenge for both defenses. But the Spartans and the Bruins are up for the challenge.
I got to make sure I contain and do my position and my job on the team and make sure I have my A game on, because, you know, it could be down to me to make one play for us to win the game. So we all got to execute.
We have to come and play sound, and we have to play better than we did at the scrimmage, which is the goal and why we have the scrimmage. We feel like there's some mental breakdowns and things like that we're trying to clean up. And if we do that against this squad, they'll score on us. So we got to be really ready to go.
It helps when you've got a solid defensive line, and the Bruins certainly have that. That includes players like Nigel Robertson, Jordan Young, and Taquay White. Those guys are out to affect the passing game on Friday night.
As a quarterback, he's going to be throwing it pretty deep, and we got to make sure that we put some pressure on the quarterback to, like, slow him down or even get a sack, you know, make offense get out there so we can score more.
Coach Dorfler is also confident that the rest of his defense can get the job done as well.
We return all three starting safeties that we did that we had last year in our 4-2-5 defense, and Jaden Smith, Antoine Scott, and Vaughn Cruz, and we also have some guys at corner that can make some plays. So the linebackers, they're two new starters, but we're very confident in what they can do.
The Spartans have great playmakers of their own on defense. Linebackers Cam Rogers and Nick Martin combined for 24 tackles for loss last year. And safety Jake Archbold is one of the leaders in the secondary.
We got guys, it's deep in every position. There's guys that won't be playing on Friday that could be playing at any other school in the SAC on Friday night. So we're deep everywhere. We're really excited. We're brotherhood on defense. I mean, it's I can't even describe it. This defense has got big plans this season.
I love our defense this year. A lot of returning. We're returning all of our linebackers. A lot of new guys on the D-line, but they all know how to do their jobs. And then in the secondary, we're loaded too. So I'm really excited about that.
This Friday night, Northrop will recognize their 1999 regional championship team. One of the captains on that team was Ben Rogers, who is now the defensive line coach at Homestead. This Friday night will likely bring back memories for him.
I mean, everybody in my wedding, with the exception of my wife's brothers, I played football with, you know. So the Northrop guys, I mean, I even though I'm wearing blue and gold, I mean, I got blue and orange in my veins. I always will. I mean, what we learned there was more than just football. It's about, you know, how to be a family, how to trust each other, the brotherhood thing. And that's kind of what we're trying to do here at Homestead.
And this year, Spooler Stadium will have field turf as opposed to grass. It will be the first time that Northrop football has played home games on field turf.
It's new for Northrop, and we're excited about it. You know, it's a first-class facility, and we're excited about it being home for us.
No matter who comes out on top, both the Bruins and the Spartans expect a good game.
Every year they come out and give us their best, and last year we played them twice, and they were ready. They played us pretty hard, so this year we're hoping to go out and fight even harder than we did last year and just do our best and win.
They give us a challenge every year, and I feel like the challenge is what makes it more excited and a better game, so I'm very excited to play them and see what they have for us this year.
This is Thad Goff for Summit City Sports. Homestead and Northrop kick off at 7 o'clock on Friday at Spooler Stadium.